time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. The responsive reading is found in the back of the bulletin. And if you would join me in the 23rd Psalm.
Yeah.
What I remember most of Monica is she would pick some music and she would bring all the people in the choir. Well, most of them are not very talented. We're not used to singing as a group. And she would just make it so much fun, and she would split us up into doing singles, duets, trios, and just pick different verses and make the whole thing come alive. And we have a mere 4 or 5 practices, and she did such an awesome job that when we performed, everybody applauded, and we all felt really good about it, and she gave us a thumbs up. She just brought that extra spirit out of us that we were, most of us were too shy to do. It was just awesome. And I remember one time, I think it was my first year here, I'm from German heritage, and she asked if I would do Silent Night with her as a duet, and I'm free, because I'm not used to doing that, just in the background, in a loud voice. And we did the first verse in German, and we had some people in the congregation that were German, and they cried. So that was just a blessing. Yeah, she was just fantastic.
My solos are like here when nobody's here, and I'm practicing or I'm home or in the car. But she said you have a nice voice. She told me that once. She said you have a very nice. She believed in me when I had that, and also the other time was when after one Christmas, at the end of the service, she wanted to do the Ave Maria the next year, and she says, "I'll get you the music." She says, "You can have a whole year," she says, "to practice it, and then we'll do it." And she believed in me enough to do that because I've never accompanied anybody like that. To that degree on a song of that magnitude, which I absolutely love. And we actually got to do that song twice, and I'm blessed with that. But she believed in me enough to learn that song so she could do it. And I'm just absolutely, that song still gives me chills.
I've been singing since I was 5 years old, and I've gotten a little rusty, but she and I got to talking, and we did a duet together. We practiced downstairs, and I think we did two of them. And I was scared, but it just came together. She had brought so much joy in my life. She had given me hope in something that I never had before. And like I said, I used to sing for my own amusement, and I used to sing in church. But she was so special. And she filled my heart with a lot of love. And I had given her a special Christmas card, thanking her for everything she did for me. And she says, I still have the card, and she says, it was beautiful. And we spoke about doing another duet, and we're looking forward to this Christmas. Doing another one, and we're also going to look into doing another CD, and maybe recording. And I can see her now sitting over in that chair with the album. And we're standing there beside her, and when service was over at the beginning of service, and after we give each other a hug, and I would tell her I loved her. And she was just an inspiration to me. And I will never forget the love that she just poured over not only me, but everybody. she between us, but we have her song in our hearts. She is in our hearts, and that will never leave. I'd rather have her here, but God didn't want that. He wanted her there to sing along with the angels. She's happy, but she's also made us happy while she was here, and that's the memory that I'm going to hold on.
Quality. Quality. She made quality in herself. And early on, you don't quite understand that. But after a while knowing her, you see that her development of her own quality produced quality in everybody she touched, everybody around her. And she had such understanding of other people, and was so quiet, unassuming. But yet that quality word I always think of with her is the quality life that she developed for herself. And in that development, and the people she touched here, she brought out the best in all of you. Everybody she was with. And such a simple life, simple person, and we all love her very much. God bless us. You've been blessed for knowing her.
A few months before my dad passed away in 1998, he called me up and he said, you have to come to church. We have a new person coming to church, and she sings, and she sounds like an angel. And my dad passed away shortly thereafter, and I came back to church, and I owe it all to Monica. she was a blessing to him and was definitely a blessing to all of us. I sang in the choir with her for many, many years. And she also would always give us a special little gift at the close of the choir, which is always very meaningful and very special, and I'm blessed with.
Please understand that your congregation in this church meant so much to her. You gave her such joy, and at this moment, you're giving her that same joy. I feel grief. The imminency of deadlines regarding her death is not so near. She died a month and a day ago today. I came across a poem from a Jewish-German poet whose experiences from the rise of the Nazis in World War II transferred her into a poignant spokeswoman for the grief and yearnings of her people. She fled with her mother, aging mother, to Sweden in 1940, just a week before she was scheduled to arrive at a concentration camp. Even so, she maintained a forgiving attitude toward a generation, a future generation of Germans. Her poem is called Chorus of the Consolers. Now read it in English. We are gardeners, bereft of our flowers. No healing herb can be transplanted from yesterday to tomorrow. The sage, faded in the cradles, rosemary, lost her perfume in the face of the new death. Even the wormwood was only bitter for yesterday. Consolation's blossoms have bloomed too briefly, not lasting for the torment of a child's tear. Perhaps new seeds will grow in the hearts of a night singer. Which of us dare bring comfort in the depths of the defile? Between yesterday and tomorrow stands the cherub. Her wings grind the flashes of grief, but her hands hold the rocks asunder between yesterday and tomorrow. Like the edges of a wound that must remain open, that must not yet heal. Do not let the flashes of grief fall asleep in the field of forgetfulness. Which of us dare bring comfort? Gardeners, we are bereft of flowers, standing on a star that shines, we weep.
I wanted you to have a copy of it, so you will see what we're doing. We're going to be putting it right there where Monica always sat when she played her harp or played the guitar. And we should be getting it in a couple of weeks, so we're going to have it up for Christmas.
And I know you well, you know her well because she spells her name correctly.
Thank you.
Thank you.
As a person who lived her life to the fullest, she was always encouraging, compassionate, dedicated, and I understand that she had a great sense of humor. But we got to see Monica's spiritual and musical side the most. Much is said today about heroes, such as firemen, policemen, soldiers, and yes, they are heroes. But Monica was a different kind of heroine. She always gave of herself to others. She touched other people, either through her work or through her music. This church family will miss Monica leading our choir. Even though she was only present from the end of November to Christmas, or for 6 weeks leading up to Easter, everyone always looked forward to her visits. We would beg her to stay, trust me, I tried. But she couldn't, as she had so many different interests and so many people who also needed her. Death always comes as a shock. It doesn't matter how long it has been expected, or how well you have prepared for it, or how many times you have rehearsed, it always comes at the wrong time. Monica fought cancer for almost 20 years, and she had an amazing life during those 20 years. But death is a fact. It causes pain, grief, and separation. It causes us to feel emptiness and heartache. There now is an empty spot, a break in the family circle, a choir with no director. And we grieve. We recall the Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.